Here's what you didn't know. This is where those guys were trained. They were doing is they were trained. Just like the German soldiers said, we were following orders. Look what this says. The cops in many cities here, not only Minnesota, were trained by Israeli police in Israel or here. Look at this. Isn't George Floyd right here? See that Arab guy? See that knee? See that fist? See that fist? He's going to inflict some pain there. Civilians. Look at this right here. 100 Minnesota law enforcement officers attended 2012 conference organized by the Israeli consulate in which Israeli police trained them. They often use knee and neck restraints. Now, I've seen the police on TV punching people in the back of the head. You don't do this stuff in mixed martial arts because you can kill somebody. In choking, you can kill somebody. If they tap on the mat, you stop. But the police aren't doing that because I believe, and many people believe, they're trained to do this stuff, to kill and maim and torture. Now, take a look at this site here. It says Israeli forces actually broke people's necks. And it says right here they were twisting fingers. Isn't this something? Israeli training by U.S. police is widespread. And it says hundreds of police from Florida, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, California, Arizona, Connecticut, New York, Massachusetts, North Carolina, Georgia, Washington State, and Washington, D.C. I think Rochester, New York, I was told by somebody. You ought to read this. Look at Amnesty International. Amnesty International. Look at whom are the police departments training? With a chronic human rights violator. Look at this. Look at this. This is Baltimore law officials, along with hundreds from Florida, New Jersey, California, blah, 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 DC Capitol Police, all trained by Israeli police using army military tactics. Tactics. Amnesty International, other human rights organizations, even the U.S. Department of State have criticized Israeli police for using extrajudicial executions, ill treatment, and torture. Now, torture, they do torture over there. They do torture. That's a fact, and they have no, somebody escapes like Argentina or something, they won't extradite them. All the money we give them, and they won't extradite a criminal over there. And they torture people. Ain't that something, you know? Excessive force against protesters. This is a democracy quote. Democracy. They talk about Saudi Arabia. But, you know, look at this site. Now, another thing, I think training is the big thing. I think to solve this problem right here, since these guys were following orders, if you sue them for, say, $100 million, I believe this is going to happen. You sue the city for $100 million, you're probably going to win because it's systematic. It was on purpose. They've had many chances to correct this. That would help solve this. Other problems is people say, well, we need more diversity. I agree with you, but I throw something at you. Those guys with George Floyd, one was oriental looking, correct? And the other one looked like he was black. So did that help? I'm not saying that we shouldn't have more diversity, but I'm making a point that I think this is going to help more, the training. And another problem is the good old boy network. We're talking about this days before this happened, me and my neighbors, how we know people that should have been police officers that were getting in gang fights and stealing and trouble and all kinds of things. And they became police officers because they knew somebody. Their dad was a cop or they knew somebody. And they have to filter these people out. They shouldn't even be hired, these people. They shouldn't even be hired. And I can mention names, but I'm not gonna. There's many people that the police will tell you this. There's people that should not have been hired to begin with. You have to get a better hiring system too, besides training, and filter these people out instead of nepotism, cronyism. You know, good old boy network. Well, he got in some trouble, but he'll straighten out. You know, and they get in there and they all cover up for him because, well, he's whatever his relative or he's somebody's friend. But this is the only way you're going to solve this. We've had 66 riots. We had the Rodney King riots. We have these riots. Did this problem get solved? No. But this militarization is what the problem is. It's like soldiers. We have to stop this. And I believe in suing many of these organizations will solve the problem. And it will put some money in some people's coffers. But take a look at this. I'm making sense. Nobody else is going to tell you this stuff. Because this stuff is censored. I can tell you that. This is Amnesty International. See? Right there. Amnesty International. About us. We work to protect people from justice. You know, and there's many bad countries. And the United States is one of them. I hate to say it. We had an organization in whatever it was, training people and governments in Latin America to torture people. You know? Ain't that something? The U.S. government financed it to torture people. And now we got a foreign government here showing people how to torture people and kill them.